Today is a national day for people with disabilities here in Korea. One thing to consider this year is the way technology is helping people live their lives more independently. Smartphone apps in particular are helping people with navigation, transport, and commerce. Choi Si-young tells us more.
A mobile application that lets the blind hear rather than see. This is the latest assistance service to help disabled people with their daily routines. Named Sullivan Plus, this app narrates objects that blind people photograph with their smartphones so they know what they're looking at.
It's very good. I'd like to do things alone, but until now I haven't really been able to do so. Now when some people send me photos, I can translate them into text and hear or see what they are. I am so happy that I can do that.
The app also makes it easier for blind people to visit places like coffee shops. Rather than having to ask the cashier, blind people can use the app to read the menu and the prices. The technology was developed by local software firm Tuat with South Korea's telecom carrier LG Uplus in charge of its market research and distribution. The software firm says it plans to roll out the app on other operating systems.
This app only works on Google's Android, but after requests poured in, we are planning to release a new version compatible with Apple's iOS this year.
A month earlier, LG Uplus and Seoul City teamed up to offer a voice-enabled taxi hailing service for the disabled. All they have to do is to talk to an AI speaker to book a wheelchair-accessible taxi. Since 2003, Seoul City has been running a taxi service for persons with grade 1 to 2 brain disorders or physical disabilities. And the city has taken this service to the next level with the latest AI technology offered by the telecom firm. To mark National Day of the Disabled this Saturday, Seoul will make the taxi service free for the day. Choi Si-young, Arirang News.